Hello everyone, how are you? I am Riccardo Osti, and today we will talk about how to analyze customer feedback with natural language processing, NLP, to extract actionable insights. What is NLP? Watch my other video and you will find the link in the description. Most companies have more sources of customer feedback than they realize. Customer surveys and reviews aside, call logs, support tickets, and brand mentions on social media all count as customer feedback. Now, if you're not analyzing your customer feedback to come up with actionable insights, you will want to start doing that ASAP. Going through customer feedback lets you understand your target audience on a deeper, more intimate level. It also allows you to improve upon your product service to win over more and more customers. In this video, we walk you through all you need to know about analyzing customer feedback with natural language processing, NLP, including why it's important to review customer feedback, the difference between data and actionable insights, how to transform your data into insights, analyzing customer feedback using NLP, and we will conclude using a step-by-step guide on how to run customer feedback analysis and how to use it. Stay tuned to find out more. Hit the subscribe button on this page and you won't miss the next episodes. Why it's important to review customer feedback. We have briefly discussed how reviewing customer feedback helps you understand your target audience better. That aside, by looking through your customer feedback, you can also pinpoint problems and solve them before they snowball into a full-blown crisis. For example, say an enterprise software company decides to scale its support team and hires 100 more support representatives to manage its call center. Now, this company might not realize that its representatives aren't properly trained and don't have sufficient product knowledge to be able to serve customers effectively. If the company routinely analyzes its customer feedback, it will quickly realize that there is an issue, and they can then take steps to resolve it. If the company doesn't analyze its feedback, it would probably be unaware of the issue until someone writes for a scathing review on Facebook and something that can go viral. The bottom line, analyzing your customer feedback can help you identify and nip problems in the bud and prevent them from escalating and going public. At the end of the day, it's important to be clued into whatever your customers are saying about you, so you won't be caught unaware when there's something, for example, a problem brewing. The difference between data and actionable insights. This guide revolves around how to analyze customer feedback to generate actionable insights. But before we discuss how exactly to do this, let's first have a talk about the difference between data and insights. Now, don't make the mistake of equating data to actionable insights. Data refers to the quantitative and qualitative output generated from sources, such as surveys, while insights refer to takeaways that you get from analyzing your customers' raw data. Then there is actionable insights, which refer to the strategies that can be executed and carried out by the brand. Let's stick with the same example of the enterprise software company. Using this example, we'll explain the difference between data, insights, and actionable insights. Data equals to product review on a website that says, I was previously using brand number one, but their support was bad, and I finally decided to switch to number two, even though their plan was slightly more expensive. I definitely made the right choice. Brand number two takes under 1 hour to respond to emails, and I couldn't be happier with the support they offer. That's data. The insight is, customers are willing to pay more for a software as long as they get good support. The actionable insight is, instead of offering a cheaper plan, maintain current prices and justify this by offering the best-in-class support. Publish average response time and average resolution time on your website and feature these heavily in your marketing materials. You see, big difference from data, insight, and actionable insight. how to transform your data into insights. So now that you are clear on the difference between data and actionable insights, let's discuss how to analyze your data to come up with these insights. If you're looking at quantitative data, this is fairly straightforward. Say that you're using the Customer Effort Score, CES, to benchmark your customer satisfaction levels, as an example. Because the CES is recorded on a numeric scale from 1 to 7, it's easy for you to track changes in your score and come up with insights based on these fluctuations. But with qualitative data, on the other hand, things aren't as simple. Say you send out a survey. Within that survey, you have a free text question asking your customers, what do you think about brand number one? What do you think that the brand can improve? Obviously, the data that you collect can be translated directly into numeric results, which are easier to analyze. Now, if you intend to manually collate and read all the responses, then analyze the content to come up with insights. Fantastic, but this will take a lot of your time and effort. Here, a workaround is to use NLP, natural language processing, and machine learning. And they can do the heavy lifting. Those tools analyze quantitative data and churn out insights that are derived directly from customer feedback. As an example, my company, Wonderflow, uses NLP to mimic the human ability to comprehend texts. Once you feed your data into the tool will work to understand the data and conduct sentiment analysis to gauge whether your customers are satisfied, neutral, dissatisfied with your product, your service, or your brands. At the same time, Wonderflow also generates automatic insights based on your customer feedback. You can receive the insights in your inbox in real time, and these are also made available through some sort of reports, where actually the tool shares recommendations on how you can implement your learnings into the product lifecycle. It's even a step ahead. I hope you like this first part. Subscribe and hit the bell to receive a notification when I publish the next video.